there is a 2x2 matrix A, and the determinant of A is not equal to 0. Now we need to show that there is also a 2x2 matrix called B, such that A times B is the identity matrix. Because matrix A and B are just some generic 2x2 matrices without specific numbers, we also have to define them in a generic way. So suppose A is the matrix ABCD and B the matrix EFGH. What do we already know? Well, we know that the determinant of A is not equal to 0, which means nothing other than A times D minus B times C is not equal to 0. Because if we want to calculate the determinant of a 2x2 matrix, we just need to multiply the diagonal entries and then subtract them from each other. We also know that the matrix A times the matrix B should be equal to the identity matrix. So let's calculate the result of the matrix A times the matrix B. In the first matrix, which is A, we need to go through the rows from left to right, and in the second matrix, which is B, we need to go through the columns from top to bottom. Then we have A times E plus B times G, then A times F plus B times H, C times E plus D times G, and C times F plus D times H. And we want this matrix to equal the identity matrix, which is 1, 0, 0, 1. Which means that the top left entry has to equal 1. So this term should equal 1. We also know that the top right entry should equal 0. This one should equal 0, 2. And the bottom right entry should equal 1. Because from the task we are required that there is such a B with the following properties, we need to find values for E, F, G, and H depending on the values from the matrix A. But it's rather tricky to solve those equations, and therefore we will try to deduce some information just like this. And the easiest way to deduce some information from those four equations is to use this one and this one, because they are equal to 0. Therefore we know that the left part has to be the negative of the right part. And remember, we want the values of B to be dependent on the values of A. And therefore we have to guess what A, B, C and D are. So as I've said, this term only equals 0 if the left summand is the negative of the right summand. And this is for example the case when F equals negative B and H equals A. And this is for instance the case for E equals D and G equals negative C. As we've defined in the beginning, the matrix B is just EFGH. And in the next step, we can replace every entry of B with its counterpart from A. So E is equal to D, F equals negative B, G equals negative C, and H equals A. And now we have expressed the matrix B dependent on the values from the matrix A. And if we now multiply A with B, those two entries should be 0, because we have deduced this information from the top right equation and the top left equation. After multiplying A with B, we get this matrix here. And as you can see, the top right and the bottom left entry both are 0. And as you might notice, the top left entry also equals the bottom right entry. So A times B is the matrix AD minus BZ, 0, 0, and AD minus BZ again. And remember, from our task we wanted this matrix to equal 1, 0, 0, 1. So we've already got those zeros covered, now we need to deal with those ones. And well, how do we get a 1 here and a 1 here? Because both values are the same and we have zeros on the other diagonal, we can just divide every value of this matrix by AD minus BZ. And this can be achieved by dividing our initial B by AD minus BZ. And then we have B equals this term here. Because if we then multiply A with our new B, we get our initial matrix divided by AD minus BC, which is indeed the identity matrix, 1, 0, 0, 1. Now you might have one more question, which is, what happens if AD minus BC is 0? Well, we could just exclude this case, but if you look at the beginning of the exercise, we have defined that AD minus BC is not equal to 0. That is because from the task is given that the determinant of A is not equal to 0. And therefore we know that we will never divide by 0. Hence, as a conclusion, we have shown that if the determinant of A is not equal to zero, there exists such a B that A times B is the identity matrix.